pass back in motion.
So first, come back to pass back with one grip. Easy for you now. Then remember how we move. So it was one step this way and one step this way. Yes? Each step turns you 180 degrees. One step. You're gonna make pass back in motion two ways. So first way is this one. We're gonna move this way from the object. So your object is in the right hand, and we will move this way to the left. So to do it, first do it with a power. Throw your shaker, catch it, do a step. Throw, catch, step. And again, throw, catch, step. When you do it, we will do it without any power. So, throw, turn, catch. Throw, turn, catch, finish move. And again, throw, turn, catch. Throw, turn, catch, finish move. So, you have to throw your shaker. After this, you have to do step by your right leg to the left. This way. Not this way, but this way. And you will throw, you will start to turn, you will catch your object, and you will finish your turn. Throw, turn, catch, finish. So please pay attention that now you are moving in the opposite direction from the shaker. So you have to throw it a little bit farther than you do usually. So usually you do it this way. Now you move in the opposite direction from your shaker. So just throw it a little bit farther. Second way. We will move towards the object. So here is your shaker, this way, as usual, in your right hand. And you will throw it, yes? And you will move towards your shaker. So now you will move this way to your right, doing step by your left leg. Not this way like we did before, but we will do it this way. Why? Because we have to turn our body this way to get your object behind. To do it, just again, we'll start to do it with the pose. So throw, catch, and then just do step by your left leg this way. And again, just throw, catch, step. And again, throw, catch, step. When you put this in, again, start to do it without any pause. So throw, start to turn your body, catch, finish move. Throw, turn, catch, finish. Throw, turn, catch, finish. Throw, turn, catch, finish. And again, pay attention that now you are moving towards the object. So do not throw it so far. Usually throw it this way, this far. Now you have to just leave it here because you will come for your object to catch it. So just don't throw it so far. Otherwise it's going to do it like this. So just don't throw it so far, leave it here and just come for it.
This move can be complicated for you now because it's hard to do flair moves in motion. But give yourself time, do not rush, pay attention on details of my explanations and you will definitely do it. Cross pass back in motion. This move is the same with previous one. We will do it with one flip this way and this way.
So, just again, hold your shaker this way, do cross pass back with one flip, easy for you, catch it this way. And again, we will move the same way, so just one step here, or one step here. So I will show it to you by my left hand. If it's hard for you, just do it in the mirror reflection. So we will move crosswise to the object. You have to throw your object, and in the same time, you will do step by your right leg this way. Throw it and turn your body. Throw, turn, and move your hand here to catch it behind your back. Throw, catch. I will tell you a little secret of how to do it really easy. So actually, you don't have to throw your shaker behind your back. Why? Because you will turn your body to catch it behind. You have to just throw it here. Not this way, behind your back, but here. Leave it here. So, your object will stay here, and you will turn your body to catch your object behind your back. Watch it. You will leave it here, and just turn your body. You will throw your shaker, but now we will move this way to our right. Like in the previous move, we will do step by our left leg this way to the right. Before we did it by our right leg this way to the left, and now we will do it this way by our left leg this way to the right. So just throw your shaker, do step, and catch it behind your back. Throw, catch. Throw, catch. Again, don't forget that you have to just leave your shaker here. Just throw it here, don't throw it behind your back. Just throw it here, and turn your body to catch it behind your back.
About mistakes. You can come up with many variations of different mistakes here. So we will not stop on mistakes. Just pay big attention of explanations of this move and you will understand how to do it right. Forearm bump. Before we start to learn it, my advice is to cover this part of your hand. Otherwise, you will definitely have bruises.
So, to start to work on it. First, do it in step. Just hold the shaker this way and bump. Bump it and catch this way. Let it free, do one turn and catch it this way. So you have to do your bump by this way. So pay attention that you have to bump it not down up. You have to bump it this way. This way. Like this. Bump. Second step, hold your shaker this way, by the same hand you will bump it, throw it, flip a little bit, and when it's in this position, just bump it. Catch it by your other hand this way again. And the next step is start this way, then throw your shaker like you want to make a bow with half flip, but do it not big, do it just here. So just throw your shaker and flip in half turn. This way. So when it's in this position, you will bump it this way, this way. Shaker will do one flip and you will catch it this way.
Mistakes.
Pay attention on how you start this move, because you have to throw your shaker here really good, really accurate. So it's supposed to be this way. If it's going to be this way, you can't bump it good. If it's going to be this way, you can't bump it good enough. So just pay attention on how you start this move. You have to control your object by your bump. Not just bump it somewhere. You have to give your object really good direction by your bump.
Sequence.
So, start this way and do ball inwards with two flips. Then, continue to move your hand and do forearm bump. Then, do palm bump, but the one half flip. So, you will catch your shaker this way. Then, do bow outward with two flips and catch your shaker by your right hand. This way. But in the same time, you have to move your body. Like we did before, we will do step by our right leg to the left. This way. So it's going to look like this. Up. So, then just continue to move your body, doing step back by your left leg. And do cross necklace with one and a half flip. We didn't do this move separate, but you are ready to do it. So, just pay attention on it, stop on it, and practice a little bit. So, we did it with half flip. And now just throw it higher and flip it harder. And do it with one and a half flip. When you're good with this move, just continue to make a sequence. So, we did finish this way. Then we will a little bit turn our body to come this way to the ground. And from here, just hold your shoulder this way and throw behind your back. Just release it and catch. Just release it and catch. Do not throw, do not flip, release and catch. Then we will do pass back the two flips by our left hand. And then we will do pass back in motion by our right. The one flip. Then just continue to turn your body, doing step by your right leg this way. And in the same time, just take your shaker hand to hand. From your left hand to right hand, take it this way, and while you move your body, prepare your hands for the roll, and do up. So again,
bow inward with two flips,
forearm bump, palm bump, one and a half flip, sketch this way. Then bow outward in motion. Then continue to move, two step by your left leg, and do cross neck pass, 1.5 feet. Then continue to move your body. Throw your shoulder and catch it behind your back. Pass back the two flips. Pass back in motion the one flip. Continue to move and take your shoulder. And